this next item, I suspect, is going to break your heart because any parent's going to feel what this mum is going through, because most of us would take any opportunity, wouldn't we, if we thought something might save our child. And our next guest is battling the NHS to be allowed to take her terminally ill daughter abroad for treatment. We're joined now by Shalina and also Dr. Hillary. Shalina, I'm so sorry. Thank you so much for coming to talk to us this morning. I know this is a battle that you want to fight, but so sorry that you're in this position in the first place. What happened to Tafida and what is her position?
So Tafida generally is a healthy child, and one morning on the 9th of February, she woke up and just around just after five, and she complained of her head hurting in various places.
Remind us how old she is.
She's now five. So at the time when it happened, she was four. And she just complained that her head was hurting in various places. And within 5 minutes, she stopped breathing. Paramedics, several teams turned up and they took her to the local hospital. From there, it was discovered a vessel in her brain had ruptured. They then sent her to Great Ormond. She was turned away from Great Ormond because there was no beds. And then she ended up in Kings, and it was about 5 hours before she had the actual initial surgery.
And so what is her condition now?
So at the moment, you know, Tafida is not dying. Tafida is not brain dead. She is gradually improving. Every day, Tafida is getting stronger.
What, can you explain that? What do you mean by getting better?
So she has now the full breathing drive. So she's on the ventilator, but she's on the lowest possible settings
so
that they can
give. So she's partially breathing for herself?
Not partially, almost fully breathing for herself.
Good.
The only reason she's on the ventilator is because at the moment her lungs are not strong enough to come off the ventilator.
And is she showing signs of brain activity?
She is, yes. She's showing signs. So she moves her limbs, she moves her face, she's able to turn her head from sides to sides.
So why then do you think that an eminent hospital like this in London, in one of the best countries in the world for healthcare, why do you think that they've decided that there's no point in continuing with treatment, that she should be taken off life support?
I have received, like, various internal information that it all boils down to resources. They are not prepared to give Tafida another 6 months, even though a top independent neurologist has confirmed that Tafida needs time. This is not a genetic condition. Tafida has a condition and the vessel has ruptured and it's done its job and it's gone.
I'm sorry to interrupt. We're always tight for time in these programmes, but how did the Italian hospital get involved? How did they hear about this?
We have a family friend who has taken his daughter to this Italian hospital for gene therapy, something that's not available in the UK. So he has been going there every month for a week for that particular treatment.
And what have they proposed that might help Tafida?
Tafida needs to now have a tracheostomy, something that we were promised by Kings before they transferred us to Barts. And then a peg as well, and a lot of rehabilitation.
Why would that help?
For the secretion. At the moment, Tafida has lost her swallowing reflex.
Right.
So she needs that for the time being, just to manage her swallowing.
And how confident is this Italian hospital? And they've done a video conference with you, and they've seen her on video and everything, and they've seen all her records. How confident are they that their treatment would succeed, whereas it wouldn't work in London?
They're very confident that it will succeed because they have dealt with many other similar cases with brain injuries.
And have they given you a percentage possibility of her recovery?
They haven't given us percentage as such, but they said, you know, we need to try. We need to wait for another 6 months to see what she will regain, what she won't regain.
And you're going to the High Court now because the hospital has the power to say, no, she's not leaving. We're not letting her out. You have to challenge that in the High Court, and you're doing that very soon, aren't you?
They have already taken me to High Court. The hearing is on the 9th of September. And
is there, Hillary? Look, any parent would want to try, even if it was 1 in 2 billionth chance. You're not going to let your child slip away without trying everything. So why can't she take her daughter to Italy, or why can't the hospital here try this method? So the tracheotomy to relieve the swallowing problem, and then simply rest under support to allow her body to recover?
Well, first of all, my heart goes out to Shalina. Yeah. We've been talking in the green room before we came in here. And you're absolutely right. Every parent would want to do absolutely everything for their child. Completely understand that. What the doctors at the London Hospital are saying is that they are acting in the best interests of the child.
Why?
because they feel that to, presumably, and I haven't spoken to them, they feel that to transport a very sick child to Italy, where they feel the doctors may not be able to offer any more than they can do here, or may make a situation worse.
How could it be worse than allowing the child to die, Hilary? You can see why.
Hippocrates had a phrase,
that, wouldn't
above
you?
All, do no harm. Don't officiously strive to keep alive. And, you know, sometimes, with the best will in the world, unconditional love can get in the way of the best interest of the child. I'm not suggesting for a moment that's true here.
No, that's true.
But there have been instances where parents want to do so much for their child that they can make a situation worse or make a child...
I've covered stories of this nature before, and I've met parents in that position, and I've felt nothing but pain for them, but I've seen that actually there's really nothing to be done. But this little girl's mother makes a very compelling case.
Absolutely.
I mean, it's a very compelling case.
Yes.
And it's not based on her hopes. It's based on the progress that she says her daughter's making. Let's set aside the Italian hospital for a second. Do you think she has a point that possibly the London hospital is worried about resources and that they feel that the chances of recovery are too small to justify spending money over the next 6 months?
Well, I'd be very surprised if it came down to resources. I've never come across a case where they've just said, sorry, we can't afford to do this, if there's any prospect of life being preserved and life being high quality.
Yes. Yes.
That, for me as a doctor, is difficult to believe. Clearly, Shalina believes that, and who am I to dismiss that? But I do think that it's surprising for me as a doctor that a group of specialists in a top British hospital that have been aided by specialists from outside that trust would all come to the view that actually we can't afford to do anything more when an international hospital could.
But if Shalina isn't in pain and you don't feel there's any evidence, even from the doctors, that she's in pain, why wouldn't they just allow her to try for that 6 months and see if there's any improvement here in the UK?
Here in the UK?
Well, I think they would.
I mean, that's what's surprising for me, is that I think if there was any prospect of progress that is measurable and objective and scientific, they would do everything they possibly could.
There's also the question of money, isn't there? You're having to crowdfund this whole thing because it's not free, this treatment in Italy. It's going to cost about £100,000 at least. It's well into six figures. So you're having to crowdfund to pay for that. Do you have questions in your mind about the motives, therefore, of the Italian hospital in offering these insurances?
I wouldn't like to comment on that, Richard. I really wouldn't. Clearly, it's going to be an expensive procedure. And is this procedure going to be worth it? That's what the doctors here in London are considering. Is it worth the transportation of a very sick child to another country where they feel there's nothing more that can be done? And that's why they're saying, in the best interest of the child, we don't feel this is right. Okay. Now, that's completely at odds with what Shalina believes, and she's entitled to her own thoughts on this. She's Tafida's mother. Of course she wants to do the best she can. But when the two groups can't agree, it has to go to the High Court.
Well, let's move on to that and finish with that. What are your legal advisers telling you are the chances of getting a ruling in your favour and your daughter's favour?
Well, they are saying there's good chances, but it still boils down to why is it that the doctors feel that, you know, they have to reduce their parents' rights. The moment a child goes into any kind of hospital stay, why is it that they're feeling they have to rush to court? They have taken us to court, and this is going to cost, I mean, it's not coming out of their pockets, it's going to come out from the taxpayers' money. We have to spend about, we've been estimated on, like, probably spending over £400,000 on legal fees.
Just on the legal fees in the UK?
On the legal fees in the UK itself.
You'd rather that taxpayers' money was spent on your daughter?
On my daughter. So where's the logic in that? You know, why are you doing this?
Let me just give you the statement from Barts before we come back to you. Barts Health NHS Trust said this is a sad situation which our teams continue to work very closely with the family to include them and offer our support. Our expert clinicians caring for Tafida consider in discussion with additional medical experts from specialist centres outside of the trust that further medical treatment would not improve her condition and would not be in her best interest, which is what you already know. So your plan is to fight this, is it?
It is, definitely. And I also want to say one more thing, that they have put up a statement in their website saying that they're supporting the family. I have written to all the directors, all the trustees. No one has come to speak to us. Instead, they've rushed in and submitted this court case to actually terminate Tafida's life.
Well, all we can say is we wish you the very, very best and for the very best of outcomes for all of you, for you and your husband and, of course, your daughter. And we keep our fingers crossed that the best happens and the right things happen. Thanks for coming.
Thank you.